is important to know that the indigenous people use their own engineering in creating their canoes, teepees, or paddle designs. The indigenous people had to know their harvesting times, the right materials to use, and when. It is extremely important to understand and to hand down this First Nations tradition to the next generation. For a very long time, the canoe was the best and most common way of transportation for the indigenous peoples and is still in use today. There are very few people who are still able to build canoes using the same methods and materials as their ancestors. Materials required: a small bulldog paper clamp or paper clip to hold together two wooden ribs for step 5, not included. One cutout of eco-friendly paper imitation birch bark canoe. Four wooden ribs, rims, gunwales. Four pieces of sinew. One wooden cross piece canoe seat. Assembly instructions. Twist both ends of the sinew until it comes to a point. Squeeze the canoe end together, but don't squeeze the center flat. Put the paper clamp on the end and then lace at the bottom of the hull. Use your sinew lacing and string through the bottom of the canoe, pulling it through so the ends meet to the same length. Tie one knot at the bottom corner of the hull and pull to a snug fit with the same length of sinew on both sides. Start lacing into the 8 holes, the same as if you were tying a shoe, intertwining over and around each other from the opposite entrance of the holes until you reach the last hole. Give it a snug pull, not too hard. You don't want to rip the paper. Continue this until you reach the ends of the canoe hull. Tie up the hull with 3 knots, the last one. The third is the one that locks the knot in place. Once you have done the knot, you can take your scissors and cut the end off. Repeat the same process on the other side of the canoe. Next, put on the rims, which are 2 curved sticks for each side. This is used for reinforcement of the structure, and you should use a paper clamp or clip on the middle to make assembly easier. Using the sinew again, lace through the end hole of the side rim and pull through till you match the length of your sinew together. Then tie one knot. Then start lacing into the holes, intertwining over and around each other from opposite sides of the holes. You should also remove the clip after every second hole to keep it together. Then tie 3 knots for a secure hold. Cut off the remaining lace. For the last step of the project, slide in the small wood crosspiece seat in the middle of the canoe. No glue is required. The purpose of this version of the canoe is to have the students or participants understand the history of the canoe and how to assemble it. It is an educational and fun experience.